Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn the chapter respiration, and today's topic is systematic representation of glycolysis. Mechanism of respiration. There are two major phases of respiration. One is glycolysis and second one is Krebs cycle. During process of respiration, carbohydrates are converted into pyruvic acid. That means 6 carbon compound carbohydrates is converted into 3 carbon compound pyruvic acid through a number of enzymatic reactions. This number of reactions is known as glycolysis, which takes place in cytosol. Now, pyruvic acid, 3 carbon compound, enters mitochondria, where several enzymes and coenzymes catalyze the reactions, and pyruvic acid finally converts into carbon dioxide and water. This number of enzymatic reactions is known as Krebs cycles, after name of its discoverer, Sir Hans Adolf Krebs, awarded a Nobel Prize in 1953 for the finding of Krebs cycles or tricarboxylic acid cycle or citric acid cycle. Glycolysis. All the living organisms where aerobic or anaerobic initiates the mechanism of respiration by breaking down glucose into pyruvic acid without the help of oxygen. Thus, initial process that occurs in the cytosol of the cell completes in 10 different steps. It is called glycolysis. The scheme of glycolysis was first described by Gustav Embden, Otto Meroff and Jacob K. Parnas in 1930, and thereafter glycolysis referred as a EMP pathway. Glycolysis is a term used to describe the sequential series of reactions present in a wide variety of tissues that starts with the hexose sugar and ends with pyruvic acid. This term has originated from Greek words glycos means sugar and lysis means splitting. The scheme of glycolysis was discovered by 3 German scientists in 1930, Gustav Embden, Otto Meroff and J. Parnas, and therefore referred as EMP pathway after the abbreviation of their last names. Glycolysis is the first stage in the breakdown of glucose and is common to all organisms. This means glycolysis is common to both aerobic and anaerobic modes of respiration. Glycolysis occurs in cytoplasm of cells. During this process, glucose undergoes partial oxidation to form 2 molecules of pyruvic acid. That means 1 molecule of 6 carbon compound is partial oxidation to form 2 molecules of 3 carbon compound pyruvic acid. See, the 1 molecule of glucose is converted into 2 molecules of 3 carbon compound pyruvic acid through glycolysis, and now this glycolysis is common for anaerobic as well as aerobic respiration. After the breakdown of glucose into pyruvic acid by glycolysis, the pyruvic acid enters into anaerobic respiration. Without oxygen, it is oxidized and it gives two molecules of ethyl alcohol and two molecules of carbon dioxide and 28 kilocalories of energy. And in aerobic respiration, the three carbon compound pyruvic acid combine with oxygen to form six number of carbon dioxides, six number of water molecules and 678 kilocalories of energy. That means during anaerobic respiration, the same glucose molecules without oxygen, it is not completely oxidized and it gives 28 kilocalories of energy. The same molecules of glucose with oxygen molecule, it is completely oxidized and it gives 678 kilocalories of energy through aerobic respiration. Now this pyruvic acid enter into the Krebs cycle and three different places the carbon dioxide is released, 1, 2 and 3. One pyruvic acid enter into the Krebs cycles, it releases 3 CO2, and second pyruvic acid enter into this Krebs cycle also releases 3 CO2. That means 3 plus 3, 6 number of carbon dioxide release during the complete breakdown of one molecules of glucose, because from one molecules it gives two molecules of pyruvic acid, three carbon compound. First pyruvic acid releases 3 carbon dioxide, second pyruvic acid releases 3 carbon dioxide. Now the 3 carbon dioxide, 3 carbon compound pyruvic acid releases 3 places of CO2, that means it is completely oxidized. In plants, glucose is delivered from sucrose, which is the end product of photosynthetic carbon reaction, also known as Dirac reactions or Blackmann's reactions, or from storage carbohydrates. Sucrose is converted into glucose and fructose by the enzyme invertase. Now these two monosaccharides, that means glucose and fructose, enter glycolysis or EMP pathway. Glycolysis is carried out in following different steps. First, phosphorylation of sugar. That means first phosphorylation. Glucose and fructose are phosphorylated to give rise to glucose-6-phosphate. Glucose plus one molecules of ATP are utilized with help of enzyme hexokinase to form glucose-6-phosphate. Glucose-6-phosphate and fructose-6-phosphate respectively. By the activity of enzyme hexokinase in presence of ATP, the phosphorylated form of glucose then isomerized to produce glucose-6-phosphate. Isomerization takes place with the help of enzyme phosphohexose isomerase. Further step of metabolism of glucose and fructose are quite similar. Equations are as follows. The first one molecule of glucose, 6 carbon compound, combines with 1 ATP with the help of enzyme hexokinase and one molecule of magnesium to form glucose-6-phosphate, and one molecule of ATP is also prepared during this reaction. Now this glucose-6-phosphate with the help of enzyme phosphohexose, it gives fructose-6-phosphate. Phosphorylation of fructose-6-phosphate. Now fructose-6-phosphate is phosphorylated and fructose-1,6-biphosphate produced by the action of enzyme phosphofructokinase in presence of ATP. Fructose-6-phosphate combines with one molecule of ATP with the help of enzyme phosphofructokinase to form fructose-1,6-biphosphate. Now, the first and third step of glycolysis, two ATP molecules are utilized. Next step is splitting. Now, fructose-1,6-biphosphate splits into two molecules of triosphosphate. That means three carbon compounds, three phosphoglyceraldehyde and dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Both are interconverted, which are interconvertible. Fructose 1,6 biphosphate, with the help of enzyme aldolysis, it is converted into 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde. And now this 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde, with the same enzymes aldolysis, it is converted into fructose 1,6 biphosphate. Next step is oxidative dehydrogenation. After formation of 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde, the glycolytic pathway enters the energy conserving phase. Here it is oxidized to a carboxylic acid, that means 1,3-biphosphoglycerate, and NAD is reduced to NADH. 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde combined with NAD with the help of enzyme glyceraldehyde phosphate to form 1,3-biphosphoglycerate. Next step is formation of ATP. In next step of glycolysis, 3-phosphoglycerate is formed from 1,3-biphosphoglycerate by enzymatic activity of phosphoglycerate kinase, and ATP is generated during this process. Direct synthesis of ATP from intermediate metabolites is called substrate level of phosphorylation. Formation of ATP. In next step of glycolysis, 3-phosphoglycerate is formed from 1,3-biphosphoglycerate by enzymatic activity of phosphoglycerate kinase, and ATP is generated during this process. Direct synthesis of ATP from intermediate metabolites is called substrate level phosphorylation. 1,3-biphosphoglycerate plus ADP with the help of enzyme phosphoglycerate to form 3-phosphoglycerate plus one molecule of ATP is synthesized during this process. This type of formation of ATP, where a phosphate group is directly transferred from a substrate to ADP adenosine diphosphate to form ATP adenosine triphosphate, is different from the ATP produced by ATP synthesized during oxidative phosphorylation in mitochondria or in chloroplast during photophosphorylation in photosynthesis. Next step is isomerization. In next step, 3-phosphoglycerate converted into its isomer 2-phosphoglycerate by catalytic activity of enzyme phosphoglyceromutase. 3-phosphoglycerate with the help of enzyme phosphoglyceromutase and molecule of magnesium to form 2-phosphoglycerate. Next step is dehydration. In subsequent steps, 2-phosphoglycerate converts into phosphoenol pyruvic acid in the presence of enzyme pyruvate kinase and liberate another molecule of ATP. 2-phosphoglycerate with the help of enzyme pyruvate kinase to form phosphoenol pyruvate plus one molecule of ATP. 2-phosphoenol pyruvate plus 2 ATP to form pyruvic acid and 2 ATP molecules. So, students, this is the complete flowcharts of glycolysis, different 10 stages of glycolysis find out by Abedin, Meroff and Parnas in 1930. One molecule of glucose, it is 6 carbon compound, it is converted into glucose 6 phosphate with the help of enzyme hexokinase. And now during the conversion of glucose to glucose 6 phosphate, one molecule of ATP is utilized. Now glucose 6 phosphate, it is converted into fructose 6 phosphate by phosphoglucoisomerase. Fructose 6 phosphate is converted into fructose 1,6 biphosphate. Again, one molecule of ATP is utilized for the conversion of fructose 6 phosphate to fructose 1,6 biphosphate. That means the first and third stage of glycolysis, two molecules of ATPs are utilized. Now, fructose 1,6 biphosphate is also one molecules of 6 carbon compound. And now this 6 carbon compound fructose 1,6 biphosphate is splitted into two groups. One group having dihydroxy acetone phosphate, one molecules of 3 carbon compound, and second is known as 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde. It is one molecules of 3 carbon compound. With the help of enzyme phosphotriose isomerase, both are interconverted. Dihydroxy acetone phosphate is converted into 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde, and 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde is converted into dihydroxy acetone phosphate. Now this 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde is converted into 1,3-biphosphoglyceraldehyde by utilization of one molecule of water. Now this 1,3-biphosphoglyceraldehyde is converted into 1,3-biphosphoglyceric acid by NAD is reduced into NADH2 with the help of enzyme triose phosphate dehydrogenase. One molecule of NAD is reduced into NADH2, that means it is equivalent to 3 ATP. One NAD is reduced into NADH2 is equal to 3 ATP. And now this 1,3-biphosphoglyceric acid is converted into 3-phosphoglyceric acid with the help of enzyme phosphoglyceric transphosphorylase. Again, one molecule of ATP is synthesized. Now, 3-phosphoglyceric acid is converted into 2-phosphoglyceric acid with the help of enzyme phosphoglyceromutase. 2-phosphoglyceric acid releases of one water molecules with the help of enzyme enolase to form 2-phosphoenol pyruvic acid. Now this 2-phosphoenol pyruvic acid is converted into pyruvic acid by the enzyme pyruvate kinase. Again, two molecules of ATPs are synthesized. Now during glycolysis, here two molecules of ATPs, two molecules of ATPs, that means four molecules of ATPs plus two molecules of NADH2. One molecule of NADH2 is equal to 3 ATP, that means two molecules of NADH2 is equal to 6 ATP. 6 ATPs, 2 ATPs, 8, and 2 ATPs, 10. Total 10 ATPs are synthesized during the process of glycolysis, but first and third step of glycolysis, 2 ATP molecules are utilized. That means 10 minus 2, the net gain of ATP is 8. 10 ATPs synthesized, but 2 ATPs are utilized. That means net gain of ATPs by glycolysis is 8. 8 ATPs synthesized during glycolysis, and after conversion of 2 pyruvic acid, now this pyruvic acid enter into the Krebs cycle. One pyruvic acid, it gives 15 ATPs. Second pyruvic acid gives 15 ATPs, that means 15 plus 15, 30 ATP are synthesized during Krebs cycle, and 8 ATPs during glycolysis, that means 30 plus 8, total 38 ATPs are synthesized after complete breakdown of one glucose molecules with aerobic respiration. In the end of glycolysis, net gain of ATPs are, during glycolysis, two triose phosphate molecules are formed from one glucose molecule, and 4 ATP molecules are produced. Out of 4 ATP molecules, 2 ATP molecules are utilized in first and third step of glycolysis in converting glucose to fructose 1,6 biphosphate. Moreover, 3 ATP molecules are produced from oxidation of each of 2 molecules of NADH produced during catabolism of glucose. In all, a net gain of 8 molecules occurs during the process of glycolysis. However, in anaerobic respiration, NADH plus H is not converted to ATP, and therefore only 2 ATP molecules are produced during anaerobic respiration. Thank you.